Good evening, everybody, and welcome to tonight's broadcast performance of the CMU Baroque Ensemble. My name is Daniel Curtis. I'm the director of the ensemble, and I'm joined here by the small but mighty trio of musicians who make up the Baroque Ensemble this semester. Jillian Bartholomew on viola, Patrick Spollinger on double bass, and Sean Whitworth on trumpets. So the smaller size of the group has worked to our advantage this semester, and like most artistic endeavors during the pandemic, we've had to get a little creative, especially to find repertoire to suit this trio. There is actually no repertoire from the 18th century that was originally composed for this unique trio of instruments. And in fact, tonight's entire program, both the trio selections and works for soloists, were all originally written with different instruments in mind, at least initially. The first piece that the trio will play for you tonight is an aria from Bach's cantata BWV 214, Tonet ihr Pauken, ihr Schallet ihr Trompeten, or Ring out ye drums, resound trumpets. This is one of Bach's secular cantatas. He wrote it to celebrate the birthday of the Queen of Poland. And in this cantata, the four vocal soloists embody different allegorical figures from Greek and Roman mythology, and they actually address the Queen of Poland directly, imploring her to different virtues and joys of life. And that's exactly what happens in this aria, number 5 from the cantata. This aria, Fromme müssen meine Glieder, originally an alto vocal soloist with an obbligato oboe d'amore part along with continuo. And so Jillian has adapted the alto vocalist part for viola. Sean has adapted and transposed the oboe d'amore part for trumpet. And of course, Pat, not so unusual, will be playing the continuo part. Those of you who are Bach aficionados out there might recognize this melody and music. He reused it later in life in his Christmas oratorio, transposing it for a tenor soloist. But here, Fromme müssen meine Glieder, in its original alto soloist key, adapted for our trio of the CMU Baroque Ensemble. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. evening again, and welcome to our Baroque Ensemble performance. Thank you for tuning in. For those at home watching, we're very, very glad to be able to share this music with you. The next two pieces that I will be performing need little introduction. If there was a short list of pieces that have stood strong and fast over the centuries, surely close to the top of that list would be Bach's first cello suite in G major. Originally, obviously, written for cello and not the double bass, this has been adapted for the bass by Hal Robinson, principal bassist of the Philadelphia Orchestra. It is a showcase of Bach's unique ability to take just the simplest musical ingredients and create something that is arrestingly beautiful that most people, I'm sure, if they heard it, would instantly recognize the tune. It has a unique staying power for the, again, simplicity and yet beauty of the music. This is one of the few cello suites that we bassists perform that we do not have to transpose to a different key, so we're very grateful for that. G major is a key that I think showcases some of the unique resonant qualities of the bass as a solo instrument, and so I hope you enjoy the prelude and the minuets from Bach's first cello suite. Thank you.
So the next piece we're going to be playing is a trio aria from Bach's Cantata number 77 titled Ach, es bleibt in meiner Liebe, or Ah, there remains my love. Bach composed this in 1723 while working in Leipzig. It was originally scored for continuo solo alto voice and for a valveless Baroque trumpet. So with this one, we were not as far off in the instrumentation. Based on continuo, we have an alto instrument on the alto voice solo part. And for me, I've opted for a modern piccolo trumpet instead of the valveless Baroque trumpet. This allows for better intonation. You know, there's no funny notes like you would run into on a Baroque trumpet. And all around, I think just a more appropriate instrument for our ensemble. So please enjoy this trio aria.
Thank you. Thanks again, everyone, for tuning in. Next up on the program, you will hear the one piece that is not written by Bach. Instead, this is another Bieber, written in the mid-17th century. The Passacaglia is the final piece in a set of 16 pieces that are programmatic. There are 15 sonatas that precede them, that precede this Passacaglia, and they are representative of the mysteries of the rosaries, which is how the set of pieces gets its name, the rosary sonatas or the mysteries sonatas. The Passacaglia is the last piece in this section, originally written for violin. The only difference is it's just transposed directly down a fifth. And this Passacaglia is thought to have something to do with the celebration of the angels. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
And just like that, we are at the final work on tonight's program. I hope you've enjoyed these performances as much as I have. And for tonight's last selection is a real doozy musically. This is a contrapuntis number 8 from Bach's late great work, The Art of the Fugue. This is a piece Bach left unfinished at the end of his life. And unspecified as to what instruments should perform it. There's even a question as to whether it was intended as a piece for performance at all, or whether it was more of a compositional challenge that Bach posed on himself. So in this selection of pieces, or contrapuntis, we find Bach at his most gloriously complex. So the counterpoint is incredibly rigorous and dynamic, and this contrapuntis number 8 is the triple fugue, so well suited to the range of our three instruments here. So again, for our final selection tonight, the contrapuntis number 8 from Bach's The Art of the Fugue. I'd be remiss if I didn't thank right now Michael Bridges, who has worked behind the scenes to make tonight's broadcast possible. So thank you big time to Michael Bridges for all your work. And a thank you to the three musicians I'm sharing the stage with tonight. Wonderful job on your performances, solo and trio. Just a fantastic performance. So enjoy the last selection, contrapuntis number 8.
Thank you.